Hello, friends. I'm here to talk about this week, The Metal Gods. I shall review Stained Glass by Judas Priest. Stained Glass, the fourth studio album, released in 1970, but it is my favorite Judas Priest studio album. My favorite album of Judas Priest is Unleashed in the East, which I should review in the future. It's probably my all-time favorite heavy metal album, but this one is my favorite studio album. Not taking away anything from 80s Priest, because I worship 80s Priest. But my favorite is the 70s stuff, and this is the pinnacle of it. Let's get into it, because there's a lot of controversy I want to tackle at the end of this show. So let's get into the songs. Exciter. To me, the blueprint of speed metal. Very kick-ass, fast, insane. You know, I always said Judas Priest, man. They're like the first band to come out and say, you know what, we're proud to be metal. Even Black Sabbath was like, we're not heavy metal, but Priest was like the only band that came out and said they were metal, and damn, if this song ever does prove it, you know. Black Sabbath, to me, invented heavy metal, and Judas Priest perfected it. It's that simple. And this song fucking rules. The footage you're looking at now, again, a plug for my YouTube channel. This is a video I made where, if you want to see this in entirety, you can see it right here at Phase Linear 5666. You can't like click on that. You gotta type it out, because I know YouTube, there's a feature to do that, but I'm too dumb to know. Anyway, I love this song. It's the opening track, also the opening track on Unleashed in the East. And the thing about this song that, like, the first time, this is the first Judas Priest song I ever heard, because my first Judas Priest album was Unleashed in the East. I remember hearing this song, and like at the end of it, where he's saying, stand, fight for Exciter, stand, fight for Exciter, and he's going higher, higher, and I'm like, man, can he make that last one? And yes, he does, because he's the fucking metal god. Alfred rules, and this song fucking rules. It's kick ass. I don't know what else to say about it. I did see him play this once on the Angel Retribution tour, so that was cool. And Exciter, man, next track. White Heat Red Hot. Nice fucking 70s metal fucking vibe. I love the riffs on this and the fucking jamming. And the footage you're looking at now is like live in Tokyo. It's not the greatest quality, but you know, hopefully Judas Priest will release this show on DVD or Blu-ray one day in pristine quality. Wouldn't it be cool? Anyway, I love this fucking song. Not much to say about it, and I got like this controversy I want to talk about, so I don't want to dwell on too many songs too long. So this one, I'm just going to keep going to the next track, man. Better By You, Better Than Me, the controversial song that influenced kids to kill themselves. I don't really want to dwell on that now. I want to leave time again at the end of the show to talk about it. But this is a Spooky Tooth cover, my least favorite song on the album, but hey, it's cool, man. I like the song. It's not bad. Next track. The title track, Stained Glass. This song fucking, I love, just comes out of the fucking with that killer riff, and I just love this song. And Halford did play this song with his solo band. I think it's on that live Insurrection or something like that, live CD. Kick-ass song, man. I love this fucking song. What can I say except the title track rules on this. Next track, man. Invader, I love this one. This one fucking rules. I guess about Martians coming down and, I don't know, doing something. This is the only song, or maybe not the only one, but I know it's the very last song that Ian Hill actually had song credit on. He actually helped write this song, amazingly enough. Actually, Judas Priest Stained Glass is the only Judas Priest album to feature songwriting credits from every member of the band. After that, it became more Halford, Tipton, and Downey. Sometimes just Tipton. But Invaders, great track, man. Next track. Saints in Hell. Oh, fuck, do I love this one. Very fucking heavy. Lyrics are a little cheesy, but I like cheese, man. Who doesn't like cheese? If you don't like cheese, go listen to Dream Theater. Nothing against Dream Theater. I like Images and Words and Awake and a few of their stuff, but this ain't rocket science, man. This is Judas fucking Priest heavy metal. And if they're singing about blood-sucking bats and stuff like that, fuck yeah, man. It's all about imagery and the metallic fucking... This is kind of like where I think Halford started to get into the monster type of lyrics, where he later did, like, you know, the Sentinel and Nightcrawler and the Painkiller, and I can go on and on. Hell Rider, Hellion, Metallion, even though that's not a song, it's a mascot of the Defenders of the Faith album. A great album that I want to review, but Saints in Hell, man, kick ass. Next track. Savage! Oh, another great... This one's kind of like the hidden gem on here. Just fucking love the fucking riffs and the way he sings it and the little changes going on. Savage is a great fucking song. It's kind of like the hidden gem. Not my favorite. My favorite would be tied with Exciter and... Well, we'll see. Next track. Beyond the Realms of Death. It's kind of like the Stairway to Heaven of the Judas Pest. I hate when I stutter. Anyway, Judas Priest discography. It's kind of like their Stairway to Heaven. I love this fucking song. It's probably the greatest Glenn Tipton guitar solo in the middle, and then at the end, KK fucking goes nuts. And I want to talk about KK Downing at the end of the show. So I need to blaze on, but all I can say, this is the only song that has songwriting credit from the drummer, Les Binks. What the fuck happened to Les Binks? He was a fucking awesome drummer. I don't know why he left or he got kicked out. Somebody answer that for me out there. I want to know what happened. Anyway, next track. Heroes End. You know what I was saying before? Exciter's Tide with... a track that I wanted to tell you which one it was. Well, this is it. Heroes End. I love this fucking song. I put it right neck and neck with Exciter when it comes to my favorite track on this album. A song I've never seen them play live. I've never heard live on any bootlegs or audio. Or somebody out there has a bootleg and audio. What the fuck, man? Hook me up. It's a great fucking song. I love Heroes End. So that's it. I really blazed through the album this week because I wanted to talk about the controversy. Back in 1985, I think, two kids went into a playground with a shotgun and blew their heads off to this fucking album. And, you know, you'd figure, you know, it would have been to Beyond the Realms of Death, which I didn't talk about earlier. The subject matter of that was really about an insane asylum guy, you know. They fed him by hand and he, you know, then he just died. But it has nothing to do with killing yourself. One of the kids survived, and his parents pressured him to go to court and sue Judas Priest, which was fucking, it was fucking disgusting how they made Judas Priest go there, and they even made Rob Halford get on the stand and sing so they could play the shit backwards, because they said, this shit said, do it backwards. I think it was on the song Better By You, Better Than Me, said, do it backwards, and do what? Do get a shotgun and blow your brains out? Or maybe do it means, hey, stay alive. Or, hey, do it, give to charity, you know? Where do they come up with this shit? You know, I love my country, but we're retarded sometimes. And I apologize to the British people out there for putting your boys on the stand. It was very stupid. So if you want to see the whole documentary on the court trial, punch up on YouTube, Dream Deceiver, that's what it's called, where they really make the mom of the kid look like a fucking idiot, which she is a fucking idiot. Unfortunately, James Vance, I think that's the one that survived, or maybe it was the other one, I can't remember. He died later. He was horribly disfigured, but he died later of, complications of shooting his face off. And it was very tragic. It is a very sad thing that it happened. But Judas Priest had nothing to do with it, because let me tell you something. I've been listening to this album longer than those kids, and I have yet to want to put a shotgun and suck on it, okay? So a big misconception about this album is that they say that this album, I've seen documentaries and I've read a little bit about Stained Clouds, that they say that this is when they got into the leather look. It's not true. They got into the leather look on the next album, Hellbound for Leather. And the footage you've seen all night, and I'm gonna pop up some pictures now, it's like Rob Halford, like, had a little sachet. Look at this picture. Durr. You know, he just dressed like, you know, kind of with, you know, the long sleeves, and he just looked very flamboyant, very 70s, you know. Didn't look nothing but metal. But look at KK. KK's like wearing, like, it looks like leather. It might not be, but it's all black, and he has kind of studs on his shit. Man, Halford gets all the fucking credit for the leather look, but KK was doing it before him. And what is Glenn wearing? That's red, but I don't know if it's leather. And KK Downing is, as I speak right now, and hopefully it'll change, it's not Judas Priest anymore. And I couldn't be fucking unhappier, okay? Because to me, Glenn Tipton, Rob Halford, those guys are original members, because I judge bands by the first album. Rock-A-Rolla had, you know, Tipton, Downey, Ian Hill, and Rob Halford. But before that, before Tipton, it was Ian Hill. I believe he was the first member. I could be wrong, but I know KK was in the band before all those guys, after Ian Hill. You know, Al Atkins was a singer, and they had this guy with an afro in the band. I don't know what he did. Anyway, I think it's fucking stupid to not have KK there. It's not Judas Priest without KK Downing, just like it's not Judas Priest without Rob Halford. I'm sorry, Ripper fans. I love Ripper. I saw Judas Priest with Ripper, and it was a fucking outstanding show. But those albums, to me, suffered without Rob Halford. Number one, because Glenn Tipton became, like, controller of everything, and even wrote the lyrics, you know. I mean, I love cheese, but dead meat, shit like that was just a little... I mean, even for me, that shit was too cheesy. You know, Glenn Tipton may be the technically better guitar player, but I like KK's better. KK's guitar playing better. It's more like with the whammy bar, kind of Hendrix-y, you know. Very, to me, it's more metal and dirty. And without him, man, it ain't fucking Judas Priest. That's my opinion, and I'm sticking to it. And here's the last thing I want to talk about, Judas Priest. Rob Halford, a lot of people don't know this out there, because every time I bring this up to people, they're like, you're shitting me. What happened was I ended up getting this old Cream magazine. There was an article in there with before Bird Steel. This was in the 70s. I think it was around the time of Hellbent for Leather. There was an article in there of Rob Halford trying to get a movie banned from showing at some theater somewhere in bumfuck America, because it was a porno. It was being shown at an adult theater, plugging it as a rock star Judas Priest stars in a porno. He made this porno back before he was in Judas Priest. Here's the article, and I don't know if you can read this. I don't know how good the text looks on the video, so I'm not gonna read it to you. I'll just give you a gist of what it says. It says he starred in a movie called Teenage Rape, where he had sex with 3 to 4 chicks at the same time. That's pretty shocking, don't you think? I mean, there's a guy that's known as a gay singer, and not that I give a fuck that he's gay or not. I don't mean to be fucking liberal, because I'm not, you know. But I really don't have nothing against gay people. I don't really hang out with gay people, but it's not because I have anything against them. I just have nothing in common with them. It's kind of like theater. You're going to hang out with some guy that's like into fucking kiddie porn, you know, something that you're not into. You're going to have nothing in common. I didn't mean to put kiddie porn and gay people together, you know, even though the next drummer after Les Binks has something to do with gay and kiddie shit. I'll talk about that. Well, anyway, I'll just say it now. He fucked a kid in a wheelchair, and he's in jail, and the last thing I heard, he got out. I think they should hang him by his testicles. Anyway, so there you go, man. In case you didn't know, Rob Halford had sex with 4 chicks in a porno called Teenage Rape. Who would have thunk it? Anyway, that's the end of my review. I'll see you next time with I don't know what band. Next week, you'll find out who that is.